I hope you are doing well. So students, today we are here with another lecture of year unit number 5, that is air of your final term. So let's start with introduction of atmosphere. Introduction of atmosphere. The earth is surrounded by a layer of air which is like a huge ocean. It extends hundreds of kilometers above the surface of the earth. Students, the layer of atmosphere extends hundreds of kilometers above the surface of the earth. This ocean of air is called atmosphere. The atmosphere is made up of several layers of air containing mixture of different gases. So, do you know that atmosphere is made up of several layers of air that contain the mixture of different gases? Now, composition of atmosphere. In our previous slide, we have learned that atmosphere is made up of several layers of air that contain a mixture of different gases. Now, in this slide, we will learn that from which different gases mixture are environmental. So, let's start. About 1/5 of the air is oxygen. Nearly 4/5 is a gas called nitrogen, and the rest is made up of argon, carbon dioxide, and small amounts of other gases. So, students, here is a pie chart which tells us about the percentage of the different gases from the atmosphere. So, this pie chart is divided into 5 portions. One is of green, that is blue, then again dark blue, orange, and red after that. Out of 5 portions, 1 portion is of oxygen, that is about 60.9%. And second is 4/5 is of nitrogen, 37.6%. Nitrogen has a largest portion of this pie chart. Then the remaining portion are of other gases. Other gases including argon gas, that is about 0.93%. Other gases contain 0.17%, and the carbon dioxide is about 0.03%. Students, we will learn the properties and uses of different gases. But for now, in this lecture, we will learn only about oxygen. So let's start with oxygen. Oxygen is an important gas. It helps all living things to stay alive and helps them to burn. So we all know that oxygen is very important for us and for all living things. Why? So because we can stay alive. And oxygen also helps things to burn. There are properties of oxygen. It is a clear colorless gas atmosphere. Oxygen does not contain any color or mixture. It is very slightly soluble in water. It means it is not completely soluble in water. It reacts with a lot of solutions to form oxide. Oxygen reacts with a lot of solutions so that it can form oxide. Now, what are the oxides? Oxides are basically a chemical compound that contains at least one oxygen atom and one other element in a chemical formula. Oxygen also gives out a lot of energy. Its two important reactions are dissolution and combustion of fuel. So we all know that in dissolution, oxygen fuels a vital load. And in combustion of fuel, combustion is a process of burning of something. So in this process, methane lights are emitted. So here the burning of the fuel occurs with the help of oxygen. Now, use of oxygen. Oxygen is used in heating and burning process. It is filled in the cylinders of divers and mountaineers so that they can climb the mountain and dive under the water easily. Third, it is used in oxy-acetylene torches for cutting and welding. So, oxygen is used in oxy-acetylene torches so that the work of cutting and welding can take place easily. The last is the space rocket sterilizes oxygen as a fuel. So, whenever any rocket went into the space, they will be released oxygen as a fuel. So, in the left of this slide, you can see the picture. The first picture is of a man which is diving under the water and carrying a cylinder which is filled with oxygen. Second picture is of oxy-acetylene torch which is cutting an iron. The third is also of an oxy-acetylene torch in which a man is driving something. The fourth is of a liquid nitrogen, right? So the question arises that this nitrogen concerns that oxygen to the colon is here. Then why liquid oxygen will lost to the colon? So the answer is that the molecules of a liquid or solid are very close together. So oxygen molecules in a solid or liquid state have the electron excited by a blue color. You know that. When the electron returns to the ground state, they emit the blue photons. I hope you have understood this topic.